Norway has become the first country to demonstrate the ability of the conventional takeoff and landing F-35A Joint Strike Fighter to operate from a highway. This initiative was undertaken in Finland as part of an exercise. Utilizing suitable roadways provides air forces with valuable alternative operating locations in case their primary bases are compromised or rendered unusable. It also enables them to easily disperse aircraft, thereby reducing vulnerability. This tactic can prove invaluable in terms of complicating the enemy's targeting strategies and overall war planning. The U.S. Marine Corps had previously demonstrated the use of its F-35Bs, capable of short and vertical takeoff and landing, in a similar manner. Major General Rolf Folland, Chief of the Royal Norwegian Air Force, said in a press release, "This is a milestone, not only for the Norwegian Air Force, but also for the Nordic countries and for NATO. This demonstrates our ability to execute a concept of dispersal. Fighter jets are vulnerable on the ground, so by being able to use small airfields and now motorways, we can increase our survivability in war." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Norwegian F-35A fighter operating from a road in Finland is a crucial undertaking. Let's get into the details. Norwegian F-35As have been engaged in highway operations training in Finland as part of the latest edition of Finland's annual BANA road base exercise. As part of this training, the jets underwent hot pit refueling, wherein their engines remained operational while refueling took place. This approach significantly reduces the time required to prepare the aircraft for subsequent missions, potentially reducing vulnerability and enhancing sortie rates, particularly during heightened operational demands. Additionally, this method can facilitate crew changes, as shutting down complex fighter aircraft increases the risk of encountering serviceability issues during startup. For BANA 23, a section of Finland's regional road 551, which connects the towns of Kartula and Tervo in the southern part of the country, served as the training ground. A press release about the exercise from the Finnish Defense Forces said, "The Air Force trains regularly operations from other than a home base to be capable of a quick dispersal across the country when necessary. Operation at road bases is part of the training of all Air Force pilots." As per reports, no special arrangements were made to enable the takeoff from the particular road. RAF Typhoons have also operated from roads in Finland as part of this exercise. Norway's Major General Folland also said, "This, BANA 23, is also a demonstration of the exciting development we have initiated within the military air cooperation in the Nordic region. The idea of using roads as temporary runways is not new. Finland has long been prepared to do this. Many other air forces, which include the neighboring Sweden, also regularly train to conduct road operations. Within NATO, road operations are garnering renewed focus, primarily driven by concerns about the Russian threat, which have been further exacerbated by Russia's full-scale invasion of Ukraine. It's to be noted here that Russia's actions against Ukraine have pushed Finland to join NATO and Sweden to push for its membership." It's no secret that aircraft are easy targets when they're on the ground, and there are instances in the past that this has been exploited. On the 5th of June, 1967, the Israeli Air Force, IAF, under Major General Mordecai Hod, launched a massive airstrike that destroyed the majority of the Egyptian Air Force on the ground. It was also very successful in disabling 18 airfields in Egypt, hindering Egyptian air operations for the duration of the war, and remains one of the most successful air attack campaigns in military history. Given the fact that Russia has a wide array of ballistic and cruise missiles, the situation is even more dangerous. These missiles could be armed with anti-runway warheads that are designed to damage or destroy runways, or otherwise render them unusable for aircraft. Going forward, F-35s will form the backbone of several NATO countries' air forces, including Norway and Finland. Norway has ordered 52 F-35As, whereas Finland is acquiring 64. In this situation, this demonstration is a very crucial undertaking.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.